kind of my personal story about it. I'm lazy enough to do tests sometimes when I commit, you know. Sometimes it's like 8 a.m., haven't had coffee yet, just want to get some good, new commit, maybe a break in or something. But Travis, yeah, he doesn't forget. I want to go fast without producing bugs, Ricky Bobby style. I want my work to go to provide value, not wait to be deployed. So I don't know if you guys are in organizations where you might write something and then it might not see production for like maybe months or weeks later. But you want that, like you work on it, you want it out there providing value right away. The TLDR is build, test, deploy as fast as possible. And the test part there is what keeps you from producing bugs, right? So how will this affect my work? So I stole this straight off of Travis CI's webpage. I've used both of these before. They both rely on Git hooks, so it's not too much either way. You're just coding, you push to GitHub, you can either do branch builds or pull request builds or both. So you have it set up, you push to your branch, automatically builds, you can have it deploy, so they've got Heroku in here, and there's integrations like for your Slack channel that you use to tell everyone, hey, we just deployed. The pull request build flow is also nice too, because you can have it do other tests in there and like let you know before you go and hit that click for, yeah, I want to merge this, that everything's good. So it gives your reviewer a little bit of confidence, right? Rather than saying, hey, I trust your work. But yeah, like I said, it also goes back to GitHub so you can see on GitHub without having to like go out to another site. So it sounds pretty great, but how do I use it? So if you get these slides later, this is a link to pretty much their full docs on how to set it up. This is one I took from a Django project. So you basically, and I have this comment here, you basically add a .travis.yaml to your project, so your repo in this case. You tell it what to build, what versions. I know I'm pretty sure Jenkins has this, but it's made a little hard to set up, but doing actual multiple builds across different Python versions, right? If you want to write something that, you know, please go like the 2.7 crowd and the threes, you know, you can have it test against all of those to ensure that you're not breaking any kind of stuff with like a, you know, like a weird print statement or something. But, you basically do install command, so it's when I'm having it install my requirements, I'm doing a migration, I'm running FlickAid on this test project, and then I'm running my tests. So deployments too, so that's one thing I think that it probably excels in. Also doing deployments, even that pipeline. So I think that's the biggest thing, is that I want to go from development to deploy as quick as possible, right? Reduce manual touch points as much as we go deploy. So they've got basically a bunch of hooks for all of these different ones, and there's more. I kind of cut off the screen there, but you can find the full display link there. So here's the part where I'm going to demo time, right? So this is my Travis CI page right here. Log in, you've got your repositories over here. You can see I've got a few of them. So we added this branch here and I failed it. A little bit ago, we can see what's wrong with it. So it also goes in containers too, which is something that I think is nice. So that's how you get like that parallelization. If I'm going to run against like 3.2, 3.4, 3.5, you can spin up all these containers, you run it in each one of them, and report back, you get logs. It shouldn't tell you yet, worker, Linux, Docker. But we can see that the command main lint exited with 2. All right, so all my tests passed. Cool. So we go down here, and let's see, it gets me a line. Oh yeah, here we go. So sweep up high, line too long. So I'm not following that bait. So what? Yeah. So let's go ahead and fix that. Thank you. So it's also a good thing and a bad thing when you go there and spread. It scares people off. I'll say one thing I like over Jenkins. Jenkins is nice if you have like enterprise kit over something hosted. This also an extensive amount of plugins for Jenkins, but the UI, and I like the UI a lot, so I think this one's pretty nice. Sweet, it passed, fixed the problem. Takes a while for this to update, but you can see my branches here, kind of like a history. Just fix this one. This is for branch builds. You can also see pull request. So I opened up the pull request here a while back, just for myself. Check those out. Let's see. Yeah, it gives you a little green check mark right there. Good, it checks, okay. So usually before you close it, we'll show you this here, it'll show you the two checks. So I think that's nice. It's really like a personal project. I mean, it's all free if you're willing to open source your code. There's cases where it might not be, be like company secrets or something. But that's pretty much it for the demo. There don't have any questions before I get off the demo mode. Okay, anybody else want to see?
Goodbye, Jenkins.
Goodbye, Jenkins. Yeah. I mean, I just like it. For testing against other things, it's nice. This is one where you can see there's multiple. It tells you like Python 3.2, 3.3, 3.4 all passing. So, you know, if there's any kind of like breaks there, if you have like 2.7 and 3.2, you can tell, you know, it's broken on one of my entries. So, not 6 compatible. But, yeah.
Have you had the
push for
what? I just said, you know, this Python is PyPy. Yeah, where are the packages?
Oh, yeah, PyPy. So this one actually, this ILO Utils, I don't know if anyone familiar with ILO HPs. Yeah, this guy. Yeah, so this ILO Utils we have, this will basically just give it a subnet and it'll sweep it. Right, so I hit the ILO thing, it'll tell you basically details on all the ILO boxes, right? You just get it back, export it. We used to define which boxes were coming online, and, you know, which ones have bad firmware. But yeah, so. Dave's good at DBA from the now he's like the DBA from the subject. So there's ILO Utils. So I've got it on PyPy, so you can just pip install it if you wanted. But I think you could probably have it maybe upload afterwards, like you could run a which will be your front credentials up there. I don't know, to answer your question there. You can automatically have it update or push the PyPy.
That was my question. Back. There is like a deploy section that has like the other section you showed. I've always had a problem with the authentication.
Oh, yeah. So that piece, we have back implementation for that. So real quick summary, three core business products in GitHub, code confidence through testing, automated deployments, improved workflows. So on my See Also page, so you don't want to store your secret key and password obviously in there. You can have it generate you encryption keys, so you'll be storing an encrypted value in there. It'll decrypt when it's time to deploy if it goes pass. So that's one thing I was going over and was curious about. But as far as
it'll run something goes successful pass.
Yep, like if you wanted, like, so if, let's say you had a Django app and you wanted to deploy to, you know, Heroku, you could have it say on success, basically do this. So, well, you'd have to do deploy for branches too, so like if you wanted to automate that. So, they've got really good documentation. I haven't used a lot of the features, but from what I have used, it's been easy to find, easy to consume. I think they are a pretty sexy solution, is how I put it. You know, like, just put a little YAML file in there, it builds, you can turn things on and off like pretty easily. So, if I go in here, I can say build only if there's a trap, so I can build pushes, so that's like every branch build basically, or if I only want to build a pull request. So, let me confirm jobs. So. That, and also their CI blog, they've got a pretty good blog where it looks really good.
Can you go back to 2 slides?
I just stole it, that was on Reveal.js. Default deck. So I just kind of was like, I gotta find a way to incorporate this. So the person put that up loop for the next 5 minutes. Yeah, we use Jenkins.
How do you feel they, I mean, is it missing features in Jenkins as well?
I think Jenkins is really good at doing customization for it. Like if I wanted to, you can write your own plugin. You can go check out an existing plugin or kind of ask them to modify it to meet your needs. I think it works really well for internal stuff, right? So if I have no intention of, I mean, Travis CI is a paid version for private repos, but if you have an enterprise GitHub where you've got your code hosted on site, I think Jenkins definitely wins there because I don't know how you use Travis or if they have
code. You don't have an enterprise?
I don't know. I think WordExcel though is the difference is Jenkins, if you're confident to set it up yourself and you're kind of open to that, then there you can do a lot of powerful things, right? Run arbitrary tasks. This is kind of more geared towards as a service and people just want to consume it for maybe the 80% case or maybe even lower than maybe 50% case and people just want to test apps or app user communities with. Whereas Jenkins is kind of like a Swiss Army knife where there's probably nothing that it can't do, right? At least it can. You can have an extra converter for a shell, whereas this is yeah, exactly. So this is more with a purpose, right? I have a 12 round language in Python that's going to pull down the Python container, right? When I say language Ruby, if I were doing Ruby 2.04, it would pull down that container.
So, enough from Jenkins. I've used it pretty extensively. It's pretty easy to deploy to internal resources that may not be exposed to the internet. How does Travis approach that?
I have no idea on that. Just guessing, I would guess maybe not so often. It's on the internet as a service, or that has to kind of hook back into your stuff. I don't know if you can tell maybe forward stuff in so they can deploy on your OpenStack instance or something. I don't know. I would say probably not well if it's internal, but if you've got stuff that's AWS or Picture Space. I have zero experience with that, I'm sorry.
Just they can run tests with private repos. To some extent, they sort it out, but that's awesome.
So as long as the level is accessible?
Yeah. I assume they have that compared to
that.
Yeah, if you have a private GitHub repo, they've got paid plans. If you've got a private GitHub repo, you can commit there. I don't think it's an all or nothing scenario, right? Just because I can't deploy, that might sleep maybe for the time being, doesn't mean that I can't. If I want a quick win, I can't take this CI. Goodness and just do that even without the deployment.
So
that's it.
So what makes me curious about it is that Jenkins can be a real pain in the butt to deal with. At the same time, you do a lot of stuff. And I see the value of Travis, but it's kind of point of doubt comparison about between Travis and Jenkins, Travis and Cloud. Yeah. Personally, I've never had any hand with CloudBees, so I don't know.
Is CloudBees Jenkins as a service pretty much?
Jenkins, that's Jenkins paid service.
Okay. Yeah. That's your problem, right? That's probably the more app comparison.
I'd love to get my hands on it. See.
Yeah. Go ahead and create a free account. I mean, as long as it's on, probably get a big pull down. You can see this one's an F5 configuration parser. I just like their UI. You can see the last six passes or fails, build histories, how long it took to write. So what Dane was talking about earlier, right? If you're doing timing for stuff, right? And let's say I've got, these are simple products, but let's say I've got a bunch of unit tests, right? For a big Django app, right? And all of a sudden it jumped from maybe 3 minutes to 4.5 or 5, right? Okay, who wrote the unit test that's doing something a little funky, right? Maybe they're not writing correctly or something like that, just easy, quick giveaways, I guess. It could also be the case that since this is on record container on their VMs, if their VMs are slammed, you might see a little bit of variance, so it's maybe not a perfect test, but it might give you just an indication that I'm going to check that out. So. Yeah, that's it. I think Dan's next. All right, Dan.